Theresa May and Jean-Claude Juncker in Brussels on Friday. AP London Theresa May, who had been damned in the Tory press as Britain's weakest ever prime minister, was savouring a rare moment of triumph on Friday after flying to Brussels for dramatic predawn talks and pulling off a breakthrough in the Brexit negotiations. Most significantly, the 10 MPs of Northern Ireland's Democratic Unionist Party, which had scuppered the deal on Monday, were talked round in late-night telephone conversations on Friday. The sticking point was the status of the border between Northern Ireland and the Irish Republic, which will remain open with no customs posts or immigration control even though the former will leave the EU with the rest of the United Kingdom while the latter remains a member. Arlene Foster, the DUP leader, said there was still more work to be done but was reassured that Northern Ireland will not be separated constitutionally, politically, economically or regulatory from the rest of the UK. Friday's agreement has the backing of Ireland's Indian origin Prime Minister, Leo Varadkar, and the hardline Brexiteers inside May's cabinet, notably Michael Gove and Boris Johnson, the Environment and Foreign Secretaries. Varadkar commented that this was a very significant day for Ireland but said this is not the end, but it is the end of the beginning. Gove hailed it as a significant personal political achievement for the Prime Minister, while Johnson congratulated May for her determination. May has agreed the deal with the European Commission President Jean-Claude Juncker, who was satisfied sufficient progress had been made, allowing him to recommend that the other 27 EU members move to the next stage for substantive trade negotiations with the UK. Getting to this point has required give and take on both sides, conceded May, who flew to Brussels with her Brexit secretary, David Davies. Friday's deal will give slightly more certainty to the 800 Indian companies which invested heavily in the UK with expectations of expanding into the EU's much larger market of 500 million. And other companies in India can also examine prospects for new investment.